All right, if you left right now and you drove west and you didn't stop, you'd arrive in California sometime on Friday. Now add just one more day and you could travel to Mars. At least that's something NASA's working on right now. Today, scientists said they are trying to develop a laser propulsion system that can zoom a spacecraft to Mars in just 3 days. And they're going to need that transportation soon because in about 14 years, NASA will be close to sending astronauts to the red planet. And joining me right now is a man who is helping NASA figure out who those astronauts are going to be, Dr. Mike Rosen, associate professor at Johns Hopkins. How much fun is this?
Very exciting.
You get to send people outer space.
Well, we get to contribute a little bit, and that's unbelievable for us.
All right, now this is what? So if you're a 50-year-old right now, you're not going.
It may not be in the cards for you, no.
So our kids' kids.
Exactly.
So who are you looking for?
So it's an interesting mix, and NASA's done a lot of work to kind of define who they think not just the individuals are, but what the whole teams look like. And some of the things are not what you'd expect. Small group living, their ability to live in small groups is very important because they're going to be stuck in a very small room, essentially, with 5 people for up to 3 years. So that makes our ability to get along with one another very important.
So what you're saying, personality is going to be driving this.
Personality, how we interact with other people, how we treat other people, is going to be very important.
Are you amazed at how many people want to do this?
Personally, no. I'm amazed that there's people that don't, but that's just, yeah. That's
and you've wanted to be an astronaut all your life.
Of course, who hasn't?
Why aren't you going?
Not in the cards for me. I have a different path.
But, so are you seeing, it's like, are they resumes or what are they?
So currently, I mean, there's a huge amount of people applying and there's a traditional selection process NASA has and they're very good at picking phenomenal people, very smart people, very motivated people. And that's what their next biggest challenge is. How do you pick from that group of people who are already phenomenal to pick the people that get to go on these missions that are going to work together well.
Doctor, you're like picking John Glenn and Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin again, aren't you?
Yeah, that's essentially. It's a whole new type of mission. That was a brand new experience for people in general, humanity, and this is another brand new type of experience. It's different than what's happened before in very fundamental ways, so it's exciting.
And the publicity over the Mars trip that doesn't come back, that's not this, you're coming back.
Correct, yes. Yeah, that was not a NASA-sanctioned plan. All intents are to bring people back, and that's why picking the right people to make sure that they come back is very, very important.
So how long before we pick the first astronaut?
That's to be determined. The first missions are in the 2030s, so it will be a while. It will be at least 10 years, 15 years. So they're all in high school now.
And you said other places. We're not just going to Mars. Are we going somewhere else?
Plans to go to asteroids, plans to go to moons of other planets.
To Cuba? we're already there. Yeah. All right, that's right. Yeah. Well, way to go. Thank you very much, Doctor.
Appreciate it. Thank you. Did you
tell your friends, hey, guess I'm sending people to outer space?
Yeah.
You're gonna tap on somebody's shoulder, make their day. Thank you. That's great,
Thank
Doctor.
You.
All right, let's take a look at weather right now. It's bad.